Hi, today I'm going to teach you how to feed your pet through its E-tube. When you get home, you're going to have a couple of different types of syringes. You're going to have large syringes that are either 20, 30, or 60 mils, and you're going to have a couple of 6 mil syringes. To make up the feeding, you're going to have directions in your discharge that ask you to mix a certain amount of canned food with a certain amount of water. You can use these large syringes to make sure you have the correct amount of water. They have a tab and you can just open them right up. And usually you'll be sent home with a box of 60 ml syringes or cc's. Mils and cc's are equivalent. And to get to, so this is a 30, you want to take the top of the black stopper and get it to the line of, if you wanted to give 30, this 30 number. So you would mix that in a blender until it's a smooth consistency, such as baby food like. And once you have that, you can make a whole batch depending on how much of milliliters or cc's you want to give your pet based off the discharge. You can keep that in a container with a lid in your fridge, or you can pre-make the food in syringes and leave those in your fridge for about a day, 1 to 2 days max. Then you would want to make more food up and throw the rest out if you have not used it all. And so when you have the food, you're going to want to warm it up before a meal. You're going to take the syringes and fill them with food to the amount that total that you want to give for each feeding. And once you have them, you're going to get a big bowl and take lukewarm water and have all of the syringes filled with food submerged in that water. And you want it to take a feel in the water, make sure it's comfortable for your fingers, because otherwise, if you wouldn't want to feel it on your fingers, they don't want to feel it in their esophagus with that hot. And also do not microwave the syringes, because that can lead to having hot pockets and that would burn the esophagus, and we don't want that. So you leave them into the bowl until they feel the same temperature as the water, and at that point they should be warm enough to give to your pet so that it's not freezing, it's not too hot, and it indicates in their esophagus that, you know, there's food going down there and it's warm. They can't necessarily taste it, but it simulates the feeding. So you want to take the cap off. And you're gonna have this tube, it might have a little bit of water that might spill out, so you wanna keep it upright. You're gonna have your food in your syringe. You're gonna twist onto what we call the Christmas tree. And you're gonna push slowly, about a push every minute or so, as long as your pet is tolerating that. And you'll know if they're doing okay based off of how much you're giving per minute, because they'll start to show signs of nausea if you're giving it too fast, which would be lip licking. Any abdominal growling or discomfort, they want to try to get away from you, obviously vomiting, and then they might be swallowing excessively, and those are signs to maybe slow down or stop and then go back in a little bit of time. If your pet does vomit, you definitely want to stop the feeding and not try again until your next feeding time. And you're gonna want to also have your small syringe at hand for any medications at home. And this is a 6 cc or 6 ml syringe. You're gonna wanna open this up and you're gonna crush all of your hard medications and pills, or empty out the capsules into either like a piece of paper, or crush them in a plastic bag with a spoon. You're gonna wanna put your finger on the end, put all the medications into the syringe, fill it with a mil or two of water, close it up while holding the end at the same time, shake the medication in the syringe, and then you're gonna wanna do the same thing, twist it onto the Christmas tree, and give all of the medication. Additionally, after every feeding or after all the medications, you're gonna wanna give a certain amount of water. Usually we recommend 5 to 10 mils, but that will be located on your discharge. So that was how you feed your pet.